The calls that he has. Hearts of Lions will fume about the equalizer, but at the end of the day, I think it's a true reflection of what we've seen. The stalemate over the course of 90 minutes. I think it's a true reflection of what we've seen.
All right, so made our presentation, we've seen the officials climb the podium and receive their medals after doing a yeoman's job, and now it's time for the runners-up. That Hearts of Lions, what a game they also had. This is a competitive preseason game. I always say it's a competitive preseason game, that coaches come into games like this not only trying to win the trophy, but they also use this, you know, as a platform to prepare for the upcoming season, right?
Yeah, definitely. These are matches that you use to unveil your players to the supporters. These are matches that the players themselves need to step up. Imagine for the first time you're playing from a lower division for a Premier League club like Hearts of Lions, and you're playing it at Accra Sports Stadium against Hearts of Oak. You can't ask for a bigger game like that, and sometimes games like this can swallow the players. But if you look at what the players did this afternoon here at the Accra Sports Stadium, I think they held their own. They pretty much played a decent game against Hearts of Oak. Hearts of Oak themselves had to step up against or to be able to get the equalizer. So I think for this Hearts of Lions team, you could tell that, Josiah, teams that will go to Kpando in the league, they'll find it extremely difficult to beat this team at the Kpando Park.
Wow, they look very resolute in defense, but as the Gbese Manche hits, it's his initiative, you know, that brought about this thing. The Gbese Manche Cup was his initiative, and he is there dishing out the medals. And also over there, you see Dr. Nyaho Tamaklo. Once I mentioned his name, without the other Nyaho, and you know, he nearly skinned me alive for that. So I wouldn't make that mistake anymore. That's Dr. Nyaho Tamaklo, and right beside him is Dr. Randy Abbey. He is also, you know, you need to clarify that.
He's the CEO of Heart of Lions.
Great. So, and these are stakeholders, major stakeholders of Ghana football.
Yeah, definitely. You can't ask for a bigger, like, coronation ceremony like this. It's been, look at how he's shaking his players.
He's proud
of the performance of the boys. And you know, what gives him much hope and happiness is the fact that he has seen that his team, he's building a formidable team that will be able to play properly when the league commences proper. So it's a proper curtain raiser for them. For Hearts of Lions, this is their first competitive game against a Premier League opponent ever since they started preseason. They're playing against lower league teams. But for them to play this way, I think basically they've been able to be decent against the two teams that they've played, against Hearts of Oak that they've played against this afternoon at Accra Sports Stadium.
But despite not walking away with a trophy, what are the positives Hearts of Lions should be taking from this? But let me remind you that the champions of the 2024 Gbese Manche Homo Charity Cup will be climbing the podium very soon to take their medals. It's been an exhausting day for them, but they showed so much, you know, mental fortitude to come from behind and win this through the shootout.
Yeah, definitely. Hearts of Oak, you know, there was so much pressure on them, especially after the first 45 minutes. They had to come back into the second half stronger and dig out the result. But they were able to manage to do that. For a fact, they really stepped up in the second half and they duly delivered. So for Hearts of Oak, I think it will give them courage. Their supporters, yes, they'll fume about one or two things, but it's a team building that they are doing now. And I think with time, the team will gel properly under Coach Ouattara.
Wow, that's a great job they've done here. And it would have been something else if they had lost back-to-back cup games here on their home turf, because you lose to your bitterest rivals in Kumasi Asante Kotoko just last month, and you are here again in less than a month playing against Kpando Hearts of Lions. I think it was just the right, you know, way to respond to that defeat.
Yeah, definitely it's the right way to respond to that. Even though it was crafty, they've got to go into the penalty shootout. But hey, sometimes you've got to create your own luck. When you don't create your own luck, luck will not shine on you. So I think for them to be able to taste that defeat against Kumasi Asante Kotoko, they are back again.
Sorry to heckle you, but that's the Man of the Match Award going up. That's been given, the Man of the Match Award being given. And it's going to Kwabena Boateng. And that's him taking the Man of the Match Award. And it looks like a golden boot he has over there as the award. That's quite artistic. That's quite beautiful as well. He has been adjudged the Man of the Match in the 2024 Gbese Manche Homo Charity Cup, Kwabena Boateng. How good was he on the day, Kwabena Boateng?
He has been brilliant for them, for Hearts of Oak. He is the anchor of the team, and you could tell that he's the heartbeat of the team as well. So today he played a great game for them. Yeah. Make no mistake about that.
Yeah, you look at the fact that he played multiple positions as well. Drifted from left hand side at some point when, you know, Efrie Asamoah Gyan was drawn out. He moved centrally and he had to pair, you know, with Mauli Wayo up front.
Yeah, you could tell Coach Ouattara is trying different permutations. And if you look at what he's doing, he's trying to get different combinations as well to be able he wants players that can give him like options. And if you look at him, he's one player that basically gives him that option as well.
So Hearts of Oak players, they have taken to the podium to receive their medals after clinching the 2024 Homo Charity Cup. And you can see earlier on was Yaya Jaman. He was playing with Bibiani Gold Stars just last season already. He switched sides. He's now a Phobian, a proud one indeed. And yeah, you look at this Hearts of Oak team. Yeah, when you win, it's always, you know, nines, the celebrations will continue. But I believe there are negatives. There are areas in this team that they need to work on, Francis.
Yeah, definitely there are areas in this team they need to work on. And the new players, they need time to settle. And when they settle, Josiah, they will come good. They will definitely come good.
But guess what? It's Benjamin Asare taking his medal. He's the hero. He actually, you know, made that save from Bismack Enim. That was the 8th. Shootout for Heart of Lions and ended up converting his kick. And there you see him, the Nations FC attacker. He was with Heart of Oak when they lost to Kumasi Asante Kotoko a couple of weeks ago. Efrie Asamoah Gyan, he came with, you know, some high expectations after scoring double figures for Nations FC in the league last season.
Yeah, he didn't come cheap. Hearts of Oak need to pay. They paid a big price for him. And if you look in that match against Kumasi Asante Kotoko, he scored.
Yeah, he scored that equalizer.
But today he came up against a player like Ebenezer Aban and Ruben Hennessy.
Yeah.
Tough centre backs that gave him tough time. But if you look at his general output, I think his link-up play has been brilliant. But you need to find himself at the right place at the right time, arrive in the box at the right time to be able to finish up the chances. But there you look at Osei Asibe about to lift the trophy. For Hearts of Oak, it's a beauty. It's a Homo World Cup.
It's a beauty. Can't agree less with you, Francis Aboyibo Blackgate. And there you can see it's time for Coach Abubakar Ouattara to take his medal. There. Oh, he's taking this. Well, you can see Hearts of Oak no more with TJ Tijani. He's left. And they announced the new assistant head coach will be working with Coach Abubakar Ouattara. That's quite a sizable backroom staff Hearts of Oak they have there. And we'll be taking handshakes from the Gbese Manche Niai Bonte, as well as Dr. Nyaho Tamaklo, and then CEO of Heart of Lions, Dr. Randy Abe, if I should put it. And Kelvin Osei Sibe waits patiently to lift the trophy. He waits. But before that, there'll be some presentations being done. There'll be a couple of presentations. Earlier on, we saw Kwabena Boateng being adored man of the match. He won the man of the match accolade in this game. And that's it. Presentation ongoing currently. But what a day it's been. It's been fun. It's been entertaining.
And the turnout.
Some hostile moment. Yeah, for a preseason friendly game. You've been thinking after Heart of Oak lost
and
to Kotoko.
The gate fee wasn't cheap as well. 20 yeah. Ghana, 50
yeah,
Ghana,
10 and so.
100.
It wasn't even 5 at the Palace, I heard. You know, speaking to the organizers, they said it was 5 cities at the Palace, so you could get it at even a cheaper rate at the Palace. And
no wonder people turn up.
Of course.
If Heart of Oak plays a normal league game and they have this kind of
fans, it will be a
good season for them because the turnout today has been pretty decent.
Wow.
Has been pretty decent, make no mistake about that.
Yeah,
but
so
the problem is the players need to step up and play better to be able to draw the fans to the stadium.
I'll be asking you, you know, from both perspectives or, you know, with regards to both teams, who your standout performers were, but there's a presentation going on currently and there's a shirt being presented to Dr. Nyaho Tamaklua. I've told you I'm never missing any of the Nyaho, it's two. So I always say it and there you have it with the Heart of Oak. I believe, yeah, that's the Heart of Oak, you know, emblem over there and presentation being done. And now I believe it's time for the champions to be crowned here the 2024 Gbese Manche Homo Charity Cup. Hearts of Oak, they had to save their day with just 2 minutes of regulation time remaining. They went to the shootout. They were impeccable throughout the shootout. They took eight. They scored eight.
And perfect that, from the spot.
They were just not easy perfect from that. The spot. And Gbese Manche himself will lift the trophy and hand it over to the captain of the club. And huge smile. That's a cute smile from Kevin Osiasibe. And he's
brilliant centre back.
Brilliant centre back. Since he came on replacing Michael Ewua, he never put his foot, took his foot off the pedal, and there he lifts it. It's the 2024 Gbese Manche Homo Charity Cup, and Hearts of Oak having crowned champions here at the Accra Sports Stadium. What a day it's been for the Phobians.
It's been brilliant, and I know he'll bring it downstairs onto the pitch where they'll mount the podium, and then the fireworks will go off. But if you look at Hearts of Oak, it's penalties. They played well. Heart of Lance played well as well. But at the end of the day, you've got to create your own luck.
Yeah.
And when you don't create your own luck, your luck will not shine on you. I think it has been pretty much decent here at the Accra Sports Stadium.
Yeah.
The Phobians, finally, we have something to cheer about, because it has been a hectic season for them last season.
Yeah.
And they lost the last cap of the season to Kumasi Asante Kotoko. And for them to come back here in the first preseason game at the Accra Sports Stadium, for them to win the cup for their fans, you could tell few people are happy here as well. So it's a good omen for them going into the season, especially in the last 30 minutes of the second half. I think they really stepped up and played some brilliant patterns.
They played some brilliant game, Accra Hearts of Oak. You talk about the season they had in the 2023-24 Ghana Premier League season. It was nothing to write home about. It took them a win all the way at Bichem United to actually cement their status for this season. But earlier on as well, during preseason, they lost to Kumasi Asante Kotoko in the Democracy Cup 2024, and now they've redeemed themselves again with the 2024 Gbese Manche Homo Charity Cup here at the Accra Sports Stadium. And there the captain is. That's Kelvin Osiasibe with a trophy and marching to the podium for celebrations to begin here. And it looks like night won't come soon for them, because celebrations will continue for them. Mind you, it's still the Homo celebrations. Yesterday was actually Homo. Yesterday, Friday, was, you know, the festival for the twins. Yesterday was Homo. Today is Mawala. So if you're a Ghana Dangbe, if I should put it, then happy Homo to you. And there the Phobians are. And I'm sure we'll be speaking to coaches of both sides in a jiffy. But there you have them. The Warriors, the heroes, the champions over there. Gbese Manche Homo Charity Peace Cup 2024 champions. Francis, just look at them. It's worth celebrating, right? It's worth celebrating.
It's worth celebrating. And you can tell how happy they are on the podium. Most of them, this is their first time of winning something tangible. And you could tell that they have been pretty decent about what they have done. It's a beauty.
And there you have it. Yeah. Champions. 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 And you talk about, you know, the right mentality for a season. And it just sets the tone for them to begin the season, at least with a winning mentality. Looking at how they went down for 85 minutes, they were chasing the game. They managed to grab the equalizer and they won, you know, down the stretch.
Yeah, it's been a tough game for them. Heart of Lions basically gave them a game, gave them a ride in this game.
Yeah.
They stepped up and it was time for penalty. So you look at Hearts of Oak, they'll be happy about this. They will definitely be happy about this, because it's been a long time coming. Ever since Amobuedu left, they've only managed to win one President's Cup, which Marvin Oklu guided them against Kumasi Asante Kotoko here.
Yeah.
Aside that, they've never won anything. So they'll smile about this one.
So we are getting ready to talk to coaches of both sides. Abubakar Ouattara, he's a very friendly man. You know, he had a pretty up and down season when he came in the first time. It was okay until a couple of losses, and the pressure started mounting. But after winning this, you think it lifts the pressure again. Expectations will go high again for the gaffer.
Yeah, definitely it will lift the pressure off his shoulders, because if you look at what the coach is doing, he has found it very tough to be able to calm down the supporters, because, you know, House of Oak supporters agitate a lot. And for them, it's all about winning. Nothing apart from winning. House of Oak is built on winning titles. You can't give them a dull moment. They will never accept that. And I think this being his first trophy for the club, he can only hope that he can build on this momentum going into the season proper. Because, you know, in Ghana, basically in the major season, we have only two trophies up for grabs. The league itself and then the MTN FA Cup. So hearts of folk, with Samuel Buedu here, in 2 years, he has won them the league, won them two FA Cups. Ever since he walked out of the door, they were only able to win only one President Cup, which people see as a friendly cup. So I think hearts of folk themselves, they need to come back stronger, because in the past two seasons, they have been off color in the league.
But Francis, there's one department of this team we are not looking at. Yes, they brought in a decent goalkeeper, but you think with Efriye Asamoah Boateng joining, they will score a lot of goals, because last season in the first round they scored less games than the goals games they played.
Yeah, that's why they went to Nations FC to recruit him. But I still think he alone cannot do the job. They still need to go and get at least one or two more centre forwards to be able to augment his strength. Because if you look at Hearts of Lands, they have Obin Junior and Abednego Tete. And when they substituted, they brought Asante.